go.
Thanks, Sally.
You don't look very happy today.
Two chips away from disaster.
Ah, but you love being on the edge of disaster.
I'm just saying that because you love me.
Oh, I love you because you always eventually hit.
You'll eventually get a tip. Thank you. I'm going to have to mortgage my kneecaps first. Place your bets, ladies and gentlemen.
17-18 split, please.
Anyone else betting? Mr. Dane?
Yeah, I'd like to put $1,000 on 22, but put it on an IOU. It's okay with Russell.
Sorry, he canceled your credit.
No problem. On 22, 1,000 straight up.
Red dot.
Man, you were one digit away from $35,000.
This is so unreal. I just buried my wife, and I am coming to pick up the baby that she gave birth to. And they belong together. He lived inside her, and now he's here, and she's gone. How can that be? And why am I going home to a house that doesn't have Alicia in it? God, what's happened to my life?
Michael, come and sit down. Just pull yourself together. All right? Because in a few minutes, we're going to go and pick up your son.
Yes, it's the same Brenda McGillis who works here at the hospital, okay? She just freaked.
Who, Brenda?
What does she do?
She left with Michael Grand's baby.
Good afternoon, madam. One, or shall I say two?
How do you know that Michael didn't set it up to kill his wife and get the inheritance, Herb? What? Oh, fine. Anything to get off the phone, right? Huh?
Clint, darling.
Oh, back from the funeral?
Yeah.
Yeah, and not a moment too soon, either.
Sweetheart, there's no way in the world that Michael Grand would have conspired to kill his own wife. Alicia was everything to him. In fact, today, at the funeral, Gabrielle literally held him together. Otherwise, Michael couldn't have gotten through it.
That's another thing. What about Gabrielle? She was having an affair with Michael, right? She was his best buddy, right? Maybe she decided to get rid of his wife.
Oh, no, she wouldn't do that.
Can you be sure?
I just don't believe that she would.
Look, my point is simply this. Of the three of them, Michael, Gabrielle, and Bo is the one stuck in jail. He's the one that we know didn't do it of those three, and he is stuck in jail. They're free. They're not being investigated. They're not even being considered. It's a damn tragedy.
Well, you know what else is a tragedy is that wonderful woman died and left behind this defenseless baby, which I tell you, just makes me want to go upstairs and hold on to CJ in court.
Cord left a little while ago.
What a surprise. Let me guess. He went to go visit Audrey at the hospital?
No, as a matter of fact, he went to WVLE. Maybe he's doing something for Bo. I don't know.
It's been a long time since he's done something for the family.
I get it.
Hey. Oh, you're back.
Clint, Viki, Tina, I'd like to meet Flopsy and Mopsy.
honey, you went out and bought two poodles without consulting anybody?
No, I didn't buy them. Actually, these are Audrey's dogs. We're gonna be babysitting for a little while.
Oh, my God.
Are you sure it was Brenda that took the baby?
Yes. She was the only one that was here.
Well, what exactly happened, nurse?
Well, she came in. She was depressed. She asked if she could spend some time with the babies. Well, I could not say no to that.
Of course not. What happened then?
Well, I was checking on the Simmons baby, and I turned around at some point, and she was gone. It was a few minutes before I realized that Garrick Grand wasn't in his bassinet.
Listen, why don't you run up to her room and check her room?
Wilson's already gone to Brenda's room.
Well, was she dressed?
No.
Well, was that security you were on the phone with when
we came
in?
Yes, well, I felt like I ought to alert somebody.
Oh, you're absolutely right. You did the right thing.
Brenda's not in her room. And her coat and shoes are missing.
Oh, man. I bet she's left the hospital.
Well, one of us should get to her place. That's probably where she's headed with the baby.
Right. Oh, my God. There's Michael Grand. I bet he's come to get his son.
Dad, what are we going to say to him?
We don't have any choice. Gabrielle, Michael, how are you?
We just came from the funeral.
Oh, yeah. Listen, would you like to pick up Garrick tomorrow?
No, I wouldn't want to wait. Why, he's not ill again, is he?
No, he's healthy.
Good. I'm really going to need my son to get through this night, Doctor.
Well, I was going to have a cup of tea, but, the non-smoking section's full, so I guess I'll just...
I'm afraid it is.
Really?
You and the baby may certainly join me. I'll be leaving shortly anyway.
Okay. I'll take you up on that.
Come along, then.
Would you bring me some tea, please? Well, I'm Brenda McGillis, and, this is Stephen.
I'm Leona Thatcher. Oh, that baby hasn't been in the world too long, has he?
No. In fact, this is his first time in the great outside.
Oh, I see. Well, actually, I don't see. Why are you here? Why aren't you at home?
Well, I just wanted a place to sit down and, rest and think. I have a problem. And I don't really know what I'm going to do about it.
If you need an ear, I have two good ones. I've raised a few children myself. I have a granddaughter who's only 3 months old. So I'm getting used to babies again.
Yes.
May I have my check, please? Is this your first child, Brenda?
Yes, it is. And possibly my last. We had a pretty tough time of it. Didn't we, Stevie?
Oh. Yoke. I'm sorry. But look at you both now. You look a little tired, but otherwise well. He's the picture of health.
Yeah.
He had an infection, but...
What's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing is wrong. He had an infection, and he... He got better, and then there was a baby in the nursery who didn't.
How sad.
Yes, it was sad.
Poor mother. Brenda, do you mind if I ask where your husband is?
I'm not married. I don't have a husband. When I got pregnant, he had to go away for a little while, but when he comes back, we're going to get married then.
Oh. Take up for this young lady's tea.
Thank you.
The change is for you. Can I give you some help, such as a ride home?
Oh, I live kind of far away.
Where is it?
Lantano Mountain. Do you know where that is?
I live just at the foot of the mountain.
You do? Hmm? I don't want to bother you or anything,
oh,
but...
Oh, my dear. I've been a widow for a year now, and I haven't known much what to do with myself since. Mm-hmm. I'd love to take you home. Get you and that beautiful little baby tucked in.
It's wonderful. You know, I feel like fate guided me in here so that I could just meet you.
Well, I sort of feel that myself. Well, shall we?
Yes, let's go.
Oops. Brenda, do you have other family at home to help you?
No, I don't. It's just me. And my baby.
Well, I certainly understand how you feel, Michael. Excuse me a second.
Is he behaving strangely or is it just me?
He is acting strangely.
Honey, I can't talk now. This is an emergency. I'm sorry.
Okay, well, I guess we better tell him the truth.
Dad, you can't do that. Brenda could be arrested. She could lose her nursing license.
Wait a minute.
Mr. Grant, how are you? We're going to need a little bit more time to get Garrick ready for you. Why don't you wait in the cafeteria?
Dan, is there something that we should know about?
Yes, there is.
Dad.
Just a minute, please. Just be quiet for a sec. Michael, you know Brenda McGillis.
Yes, her baby died last night.
Yes, and she's become extraordinarily upset about it. And I don't know, something's happened to cause her to become emotionally unstable. Michael, she took your baby out of the ICU room a little while ago.
Took him? Took him where?
Well, I don't know.
Wait. Are you saying that he's kidnapped? Are you telling me that?
Did she take him out of the hospital?
I just don't know. We've got security checking the hospital.
Have you called the police?
Well, we're hoping to find her first, Mr. Grant.
Well, you just said that she was unstable. Call the police now!
You're absolutely right.
Dad, come on.
Dan, I can't. You put yourself in Mr. Grant's position. You call Wanda. Have her check on Brenda's house. Maybe she's there.
All right.
Please. Is this possible? How much more am I supposed to go through, huh?
I don't know. Look, don't worry. We have to trust that she will bring your son back to you.
I don't trust anything anymore. Nothing.
All right, the call of Rafe Garrison and the police are now officially involved.
Why would she do something like this? Do you have
Michael, any idea? Michael, Brenda is suffering the same kind of pain that you were feeling over Alicia. And she just can't stop denying that her baby is dead.
Are you saying that she took my son thinking that he's her son?
I think that's what happened. And given that she's so level-headed normally, something must have happened. Something must have snapped to cause her to do that.
I don't think I can sit around patiently while this thing works itself out. I mean, enough is enough. God!
Michael! What adorable little dogs! How cute! Oh, gosh, wait till Joey sees this. He asks me once a week when we're going to get a dog.
Hey, no kidding. Once we have these little guys around here for a little while, you're going to have to go out to the store and buy a couple. Just how long they gonna be staying with us? I don't rightly know, Clint.
Why are they staying with us?
Well, honey, what's wrong? I thought you liked dogs.
I do. I love dogs. I just wonder if Audrey didn't have some friends before she met you. I mean, why are these things your responsibility now?
Well, I just kind of took it upon myself. See, the person who was watching the dogs is going out of town for a couple of days. I told Audrey I would pitch in and pick up the slack. That's where I was over WBLE picking up the dogs right now. Listen, Viki, Clint, if you got a problem with this...
No, good heavens, I don't mind at all. They're absolutely adorable little doggies. The kids are going to love them.
Yeah, I bet they are.
What if they don't love kids? Well, I mean, some dogs don't, you know, and I doubt that Flopsy and Mopsy have spent a lot of time around children.
Well, Audrey tells me that they just love kids.
Well, why don't we go upstairs and find out if it's true or not, just to make sure.
Yeah.
Good idea.
Good.
Honey, come on. I can't wait to see CJ's face light up when he sees these little guys.
Yeah.
Well, honey, I have to talk to Viki.
Oh. So,
Cord.
Which one's Flopsy and...
You got him?
Which one's Mopsy?
Well, I think you got Mopsy. No, wait, no.
No, I got Mopsy. That's Flopsy.
I have a problem.
Yeah. I noticed it.
What do you think it is?
I think you're jealous of Audrey.
Do you think Cord sees it?
If he hasn't seen it yet, he's going to very soon. What's the problem? What's wrong?
I don't know. I keep telling myself it's all in my mind, but then my mind tells me that maybe there is a reason for me to be jealous.
Place your bets, ladies and gentlemen. Place your bets.
I'll put $200 on this corner right here.
Mr. Dane? No, ma'am, I'm not really happening tonight.
Wait, one more.
Yes, ma'am.
100, straight up and six.
$13,
black and eye. Excuse me, excuse me. Could you tell me where I could trade in my money for some chips?
I hope so, since this is my casino.
Oh, no, you're kidding me. Really? This is my first time in Atlantic City. Tell me, is it good luck when you meet the owner?
You can buy your chips right away.
Yeah.
Bets? No. Jimmy, I don't think it'd be a good idea for you to leave after just one roll. You have to give the luck a chance to kind of click in there. Maybe you need a little help. You need a little instruction, a partner, a guru here. You know, you're really very attractive, and I'm not doing anything
right now.
Is your
name Marco Dane?
Yes, it is.
I thought so. My friend Marilyn warned me to watch out for you.
All right.
Marco, Marco, how many times have I asked you not to hit on the ladies?
I beg your pardon? How much money have you made for my assisting the ladies?
I've grown very tired of you lately.
You've grown tired of me lately.
You should be moving on, say, to Monte Carlo or Las Vegas. I think all your luck has run out in Atlantic City.
Really? What an interesting concept. Maybe you're right.
I'm quite definitely right about your luck in my casino. I understand you're into me for about $100,000.
So what's the big deal?
Yes, it is a big deal. I want to be paid tonight before you leave.
You want to be paid tonight?
That's right. That way I won't have to hunt you down to hurt you.
Hey, man, what's all this about? You know I'm good for my debts.
In the old days, yes. Like I said, your luck has run out in Atlantic City, Mark. Tonight, $100,000.
All bets?
Well, hello, Fury. You know how to play this game right here?
Roulette, yeah, sure.
Yeah? Well, you want to teach me how to play?
You got money?
Sure, I got money.
You got money to burn?
Yeah, money to burn.
All right, let's get down to it.
I got me here $100.
Has Cord given you any reason at all to think that you should be jealous?
Oh, reasons other than that he's going to the hospital every chance he gets to visit Audrey, or that he can't sleep at night because he's feeling so guilty. You mean other reasons than those?
I mean, that's only temporary.
Why do you say that?
Because it only just happened. Because Cord was there. He saw Audrey get hit by the car. In fact, mostly because he feels the whole thing wouldn't have happened at all if he hadn't pushed her out into the road.
I know, because of the fight. And the fight, well, I mean, he pushed Audrey out of the way because her old boyfriend had this knife that he was going to plunge right into Cord. I know all that, and it is so stupid that he feels guilty. I mean, he was just trying to help her.
Sweetheart, that's all Cord is trying to do for her now, to be a concerned friend. You know yourself. When you feel guilty about something, you lose your perspective. Cord probably feels that he has to do more for Audrey right now. But, honey, once she starts to improve, I'm sure...
Yeah, but she may not improve. I mean, the doctors don't know if she's ever going to walk again. So does this mean Cord is going to feel guilty for the rest of his life? Or maybe that we're going to have to move her in here so we can all take care of her?
I want you to think back to about 20 minutes ago when you were riding in the car with me coming back from the funeral. How you were telling me what a fabulous friend Gabrielle could be. And how she's doing everything under the sun right now for Michael.
What about it?
Darling, you admired that kind of friendship. That's all that Cord is doing for poor Audrey. I mean, if it were a male friend, would you mind?
I knew you'd ask that. And yes, I would mind. But not as much.
Is there any reason to believe that your marriage is in trouble? I mean, or that Cord is falling out of love with you? Certainly no reason to believe that he doesn't find you sexually attractive anymore.
Of course not.
Well, then you'd better stop being so insecure. Because you're creating one great big problem where there isn't any.
And in court's eyes, I'm going to look pretty petty, won't I?
Yeah.
Like I already did with those two cute little doggies, right?
Yeah.
I don't know why I get so insecure, but I do. But I don't do it on purpose.
Well, of course you don't do it on purpose. You know, why don't you go to the hospital with Cord? Try and spend some time with Audrey. You might even try and become her friend.
Well, you know, she's pushed away all her old friends and stuff. I mean, that's the really weird part. Cord is the only person that she will even let near her.
Nonetheless, you could make the effort. And if Audrey doesn't want your friendship, at least Cord will appreciate it, won't he? And then you'll feel better about what he's doing.
You're right. You're always right. Okay, I will try really, really hard. I will. But I may need to talk to you about this again.
Anytime.
Okay.
Oh, excuse me. Ladies, look, you got to come upstairs real quick. CJ, Jessica, Flopsy, and Mopsy, they're like the funniest foursome you'll ever see.
Come on, Tina.
Oh, Cord, honey, I'm so sorry. I was in a bad mood. I am. Honey, and I think it's great that we have, that you brought those two cute little doggies home.
Well, good. Well, come on, let's go see this. Come on, let's take some pictures.
No, Brenda is not at her house, and she hasn't been in the... Her car is in the garage.
Do you think Brenda's coherent enough to know we'll be looking for her?
Rafe, you gotta know this. Brenda must really have believed that that baby was hers for her to have done this.
Look, I know Brenda is a great person, and she's just not in her right mind now. But this is kidnapping. I'm gonna have to call in the federal authorities if she doesn't show up soon.
Rafe, you can't do that.
I'm mandated by law to do it, Dan.
But immediately?
No, I can hold off till midnight. Hopefully we'll find her or she'll come to her senses and return by then.
There's a telephone call for you, Captain.
Thank you. Excuse me.
Well, listen, we gotta do something to find her. If they call the feds in or if Michael Grant presses charges.
Yes, I know that, Larry. But if she didn't get on a plane to see her father and her brother, I cannot imagine where she is.
All right, wait a minute. Let's go back over the conversation you had with her. Maybe there's some clue we're missing.
Well, it seemed to me like she accepted the truth. She kept saying over and over that she was wondering how she could lose Steve and her baby son. And then she started telling me about dreams that they'd had, about how Steve was going to build them a place outside Llanfair, in the mountains, and how they had decided it was going to be a cozy cabin and not some kind of a big modern house or something.
Brenda and the baby were seen at Barry's restaurant. They left with an unidentified woman. It was about an hour ago.
With someone she knew?
According to the maitre d', they only met when the woman offered Brenda the table or something.
Well, maybe the woman drove her someplace.
Yeah, but where? I need to know the answer to that, and soon.
All right. Excuse me. I'll be back.
The key should be in that second flower pot. Oh. Right, that one right there is... Oh, here it is.
Oh,
great. See this? Okay.
What a lovely place you have here, Brenda.
Yeah, we just had it renovated.
Oh, it smells a little stuffy, though. Should I open some windows?
No, please. I don't want the baby to get chilled, okay?
Sweetie, I'm going to worry about you out here so far from civilization.
No, Leona, I'm going to be fine. I'm having my car brought up tomorrow. You're going to be fine, okay?
Phone hooked up?
Yeah, phone's hooked up. Everything's good. And the father of the baby's going to be here real soon to look after us, okay?
Can I fix you something to eat?
No, please. You've been great, but I think you should leave. Because I'm tired. And I want to feed the baby and then just curl up and take a nap and stuff, okay?
Yes, I'm sure you both need it.
Yeah, we do.
Look, I'm going to write down my telephone number here. I want you to call me if you need anything.
All right, I will, I promise.
In fact, I want you to call me in the morning.
Okay.
Tell me you're fine, say hi.
Okay, mm-hmm. Great. I think you should go now because mm-hmm. It's getting dark and that road down Llanfair Mountain is kind of scary at night, okay?
You two have fun. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Tonight, we are going to be together. And nobody's going to take you away from me. Ever. 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 Ever.
Oh, there you are. I've been looking all over for you. Listen, Viki and Clint went over to see Bo, and I kind of need to split myself to go over to the hospital.
Oh, well, that's why I was out picking these. I thought you could give them to Audrey.
Really? Honey, that's so sweet of you. Thank you. You know what? I bet this puts a great big smile on Audrey's face. Thank you, honey.
Well, I was even thinking maybe I could go with you. I mean, well, maybe she doesn't want me hanging around or anything, but I could just tell her how much the kids are enjoying the dogs, and then I could wait for you, and then...
And then what?
Then we could have a really nice dinner, a romantic dinner, just the two of us.
Yeah. And then maybe we could come home early and have a little more romance.
Exactly.
Listen, honey, I hope you don't think that I've been neglecting you and CJ lately. You know, you two are the most important people in my life. It's just that Audrey is, well, she's really going through a bad time right now. And for some reason, it seems like I'm the only person who can get through to her.
You don't have to worry about it anymore, right? I mean, CJ and I both miss you. We miss you an awful lot. But we also both know that you still love us.
On a $20 bet, how much you win?
Odds on a six line, 6 to 1.
5 to 1.
Oh, yeah, 5 to 1, I'm sorry. Okay, so that means that he wins $100. So what? That's nothing compared to what he could win 35 to 1, right? No one wins that, though, huh?
Yeah, well, I used to be able to.
Oh, yeah? It's all luck, isn't it?
No, it's all feel.
Place your bets, ladies and gentlemen.
Sometimes you just get a feel. You get a feel for the way the wheel's spinning. You get a feel for the room. You get a feel for the numbers. Numbers start popping off inside your head. They start screaming at you. Play me, play me. You play them.
Mm-hmm. And you're telling me those numbers always win.
No, they don't always win because you hear other voices, too. You hear the bad voices. They're saying play me, too, on the wrong numbers. You play them, you lose. I wish I could show you instead of just talking about it.
So, how do you tell the difference between the numbers?
Nine, right now.
You don't always tell the difference between the numbers.
What? Wait a minute. You're putting me on. Are you telling me you can never tell the difference between the numbers?
You know, sometimes. Sometimes I'm like a Zen gambler. I feel the numbers, and I can't lose. I feel the number. I see the number, I hear the voices, I am the number. I play it, and it hits. It's another thing I wish I could show you instead of just talking about right now.
Well, let's do it.
No, I mean,
play.
I just can't really do that at the moment.
Why?
I'm
Why
just
not?
I'm really not feeling very zen-like right now. I'm sorry, maybe our luck's going to change with you. Maybe the minute you walked in the room, you were already there.
Yeah, yeah, you see? Now, excuse me, girl. Now, you're never going to know this unless I place my bet, you know? Now, the limit is 10. I'm going to give 10. We're going to play. Excuse me, croupier.
Yes, ma'am.
I've got to put $10 straight up on number 9. What's wrong?
Well, I mean, 9 hasn't hit in about a year.
Yeah, well, 9 is my favorite number.
So maybe I was wrong about who you are.
What do you mean, who I am?
The woman of my dreams. Come on, come on, come on.
And the number is?
Nine, written out.
Nine? Thank you very much. $350. You told me that nine never hit.
Yeah, well, nine hasn't hit for about, you know, maybe you are the woman of my dreams. Can you do that again?
Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm.
Want to place another bet?
Seven straight up.
Okay, I'm going to put my winnings right here on number 10.
What is it? Can we go with this? Come on, man. 10, 10, what are you doing with 10 over there? Number. You can't do that. What am I, your spiritual advisor? Not.
What are you telling me? I'm going to lose my $350?
What's your name?
Where is
Ruby.
Black and Eve.
Ruby's got kind of the range.
10. 10.
10.
I just won.
10.
Thank you very much.
God, no, what's that? $350 on there? You win 35 times $350. That's, what is that? That's, 12,000. That's, how much? You better count that. Double check this stuff. Hey, maybe you are the woman of my dreams.
Not bad, huh? So what's your name?
Marco. Listen, Marco Dane wants you to bet this for him. Why don't you turn that into $35,000? I'm gonna break Russell's bank. Come on.
Today, discover.
Come on, we're gonna hit, we're gonna like, cause movie bride is mine tonight. Come on, baby. Come on.
Oh!
28. We hit.
Hey,
we hit.
We're rich. We're
That's
rich.
Great. Oh, wow. Okay, come on. We're gonna hit, we're gonna like, cause Ruby Light. Ruby Bride is the gem of the day. Why am I acting like this?
Well, I think $35,000 in one fell swoop.
That's right.
Is a pretty good amount.
This is mine,
you know,
right?
Me?
Right, good.
Okay, money, money.
Thinking of numbers? Get
okay,
a number.
I'm
Let's
thinking,
think of
okay, all right, let me think, you know. Two. I'm gonna
sure it's two. Feels
definitely
like
two. Definitely
we're gonna put five. We're gonna put let's put $10,000. Let's put $20,000 on two.
Okay.
All right.
About me. You know my money too.
Yeah. Okay. Sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Ready? Come on. Hit it. Let's roll.
Any more bets, please?
We're gonna hit. We're gonna like, cause Ruby Bright is the gem of the night.
Come
I can't
on,
look. Just tell me when it hits on two. To hit on
two.
Black and
two.
Two.
Two. Ruby, I can't believe it, man. Here, I was running out of money. This girl comes walking in, and all of a sudden, we're gonna hit, we're gonna lie, because Ruby Bryce and Jam of the night. She's out of sight. She's doing fine. Yo, Ruby! I love you, baby. Let's bring in some more money. What's the next bet? Come on. We got it.
Ollie, you see that little guy at the roulette table making a fool of himself?
Yes.
Have you ever seen him before?
No.
Has he ever seen you?
No.
Good, I don't want him to be able to connect you to me. He owes me $100,000. I don't want him to pay so I can get him out of my casino for good. But it seems he's got a streak going now. Make sure he ends up penniless this evening, right? Before he has a chance to pay me back.
Gotcha, boss.
Tell me again that this is not punishment for all my sins.
It's not.
And do you really think that she's gonna bring the baby back on her own, or that they'll at least find her?
Yes, Michael, I believe that.
Good. Because I don't think I can go on without my son.
You're not going to lose him, do you hear me? And you're not going to do anything foolish, so don't even think that way. Listen to me. Brenda is going to realize that the baby she has is your son, Garrick. She is going to bring him back to you.
Maybe I should call the hotel. Try and put my mind on some business.
Oh, it's today the 18th.
Yeah? Oh,
completely forgot the French ambassador.
Right, the mayor's reception.
Yeah, look,
ball.
Don't you even worry about it. I'll take care of it, okay?
Right.
I'll be right back.
Gabrielle, be careful. If anything happened to you right now, I would be completely lost.
Don't worry.
Thank you.
That thing at the hospital has kind of fouled us up, hasn't it? It has. But we are going to get over it and around it. Because I know who you are. And you know who I am. You look just like your daddy. Yes, you do. Oh, honey. We'll just worry about all that stuff a little later. Tonight, we're going to be together. Just like this.
Okay. The number is 4, black and even.
Oh, bummer, bummer, bummer.
Honey, I think our streak is over. It's time to split.
Well, are you sure?
Yeah. Hear any voices?
No.
It's time to split.
Yeah, but, you know, I got $1,000 here, and you got $100,000.
The first thing you got to learn about in gambling is that when the streak is over and it's time to go, you go. I mean, we had some luck, but it's gone now. Okay? You plan on being around tomorrow?
Well, I wasn't planning on coming back here tomorrow, but, you know, I don't know, maybe. I'm kind of like a free spirit, you know? Maybe I will, yeah.
You have to be someplace else?
Well, you know, I do have to get back to South Philly at some point. Yeah, I got to leave eventually, yeah.
All right, listen, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine. Now, you might think you got here all on your own accord, but as a matter of fact, you didn't. See, it's all under the auspices of one certain Madam Irma.
Irma? Who's this chick, Irma?
Well, let's cash in all this stuff. Can you give us some cash for this?
Just so I can give you some bigger checks. Take them to the cage.
Yeah, do that. And we'll go meet Madam Irma now. Come on.
I'll make my move soon, boss.
Don't lose Marco, whatever you do.
I'm sorry to burst in on both of you, but I tried phoning. The line was busy.
Well, what is it? You look frantic.
Yeah, please, set yourself down, girl.
No, it's all right. Something awful has happened. Brenda has taken Garrick from the hospital. Was she left the hospital?
Wait a minute, are you talking about she accidentally left with the baby or something?
No, you did hear that Brenda's baby died.
Yeah?
You mean you're saying she had on purpose? She took Garrick?
Yes.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, my goodness. I feel so bad for Michael, but, you know, I feel even worse for Brenda. I mean, that baby was all she had left of Steve, and his dying. Oh, it must have been horrible for her.
Yes.
Listen, is there anything we can do?
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, there is. Well, you see, the mayor invited the French ambassador to the party at the hotel tonight, but if Michael and I cannot be there, then we need someone to cover for us, and I was wondering if you wouldn't mind doing that.
Oh, well, Cord and I had plans. We... Ooh. How can I say no?
That's right. That's all right, Gabrielle. With everything Michael's going through right now, the last thing he needs to worry about is his hotel.
Oh, thank you both so much.
Yeah, well...
Would you also mind going over there now?
Sure. Sure, I'll just go throw on something a little more appropriate.
Dana, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Gabrielle, listen, again, I understand everything that Michael's going through right now. It's just, I don't know if you've had a chance to talk to him to make him realize that Bo is not the one who killed his wife.
Well, we don't know that for a fact. We don't know that he's innocent.
Yes, we do know that he is innocent. Listen, maybe you could talk to Michael, all right? Maybe find out if he had any other enemy, someone who might have done something like this to him.
No, there is no one else, Cord.
Gabrielle Bo is not a murderer.
All right, I'll talk to him, but that's all I can promise.
Thank you.
Brenda? I know you're in there, Brenda. Honey, please, open the door. If you don't, I'm going to find something and break the lock.
Okay. Okay, Larry.
Oh, thank God you're all right.
Oh, God. How did you know I was here?
Well, I just guessed. Are you okay?
Yeah, look, he's just fine. I just fed him, and I'm going to lay down with him for a little bit. Oh, Larry.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Baby, I'm looking at you because I love you so much. God, I was so scared when you took Rick and left the hospital.
Not Rick. Brenda. Not Rick, it's Stephen. It's Stephen Holden McGillis. And if you came out here, Larry, to tell me that this isn't my son, you wasted a lot of gas and a lot of tire tread. You hear me?
Listen, I have never lied to you. Honey, why would I want to hurt you by telling you your son died if he hadn't?
I don't know. I guess you're just confused. But I am not confused. This is my baby. And if you try to take him away from me, I will do anything. Anything. To keep and prevent you from taking my boy. Do you hear me?